Yes.
Okay. So for example, foundation mathematics, firstly we will learn about intervals. We will learn about solving inequality, okay? So how to solve an inequality? So to solve inequality, we just remind two things. Number one is, if we multiply or divide using a minus sign, if we multiply or divide using a minus sign, then this inequality sign will be reversed, okay? For example,
okay.
For example, here I have, you can see here, right? Minus x is greater than 2. So I need the value of x. So that for this, I just multiply minus here and also here. So if I multiply minus, so this sign will be reversed. So here it becomes plus x is less than minus 2. Okay?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So here is two simple rules to solve any inequality. So let's go to the number one. And here we have 5x minus 3 is less than or equal to 7 minus 3x. So we have to keep only x on the on side and everything else on the other side, okay? Because we need the value of x. So for this reason, here we can just take all x on the left side and everything, all numbers on the right side. So you know that plus becomes minus, right? And minus becomes
yes.
plus. And multiply becomes division. And division becomes multiplication, okay? So if we change the side, that means if I take this minus 3x from here to here, it will become plus 3x. So 5x plus 3x, and I take this minus 3 from here to here. So it becomes 7 plus 3, that means 10. And now we have 5 plus 3, that means 8x. 8x is less than or equal to 10. And if I divide, if I take this 8 from here, left side to right side, so it will be divided, right? 10 divided by 8. And now if we simplify this, 10 divided by 8, we divided it using 2, right? 10 divided by 2
yes.
and 8 divided by 2, okay? So it becomes 5 divided by 4. So x will be, the value of x is less than or equal to 5 by 4. So that's why our interval will be a closed interval. Because if there is something like greater than equal to or less than equal to, then the interval is a closed interval, okay? And we can see here our value is less than or equal to 5 by 4. So 5 by 4 is a positive number, right? So here is 0 and here is 5 by 4. So we have to take from here 5 by 4 to minus infinity, okay? Because x is less than or equal to 5 by 4, that means here. So this way we solve any interval inequality. So let's see some more example for something like different, okay? For example, here we have modulus. We have to solve inequality of absolute value, right? So for mm-hmm. absolute value, we have only two rules. If you remind two rules, you can solve all other things. One is here and another one is here, okay? This one and this one. So if modulus x is less than a, then the value of x will be greater than minus a and less than plus a, okay? And if modulus x is greater than a, then x will be greater than a or less than a. So if I draw this in a line, so you can imagine this. So for modulus x is less than a, our value will be, suppose this is our minus a and this is our plus a, right? So our value will be in between these two points. Okay. And if this is greater than, if modulus x is greater than a, then the point will be from minus infinity to from minus a to from minus a to minus infinity, and from a to plus infinity. Okay.
Okay.
So for this, we write this way. Like, here is an example. Let me show you. Here is an example. Modulus x is less than 2, right? So x will be greater than minus 2 and less than plus 2. So this is our minus 2 and this is our plus 2, and all the intervals will be in between these two points. Okay, that's why our solution set is open interval, and our interval is minus 2 comma 2. So if this is something like greater than or less than, then it is an open interval. And if this is something like greater than equal to or less than equal to, then it is a closed interval. Okay. So here we have what? Here we have only greater than or less than, right? So that means it is open interval. And there is something like, for example, minus 2 is greater than x. X is greater than minus 2 or less than or equal to 5. So this is called half open interval. This is called half open. You can see here, this is open and this is closed. So how will be this? This will be, here is minus 2, and for example, here is our 5. So this 5, we just make it a solid circle, okay? Because this is a closed interval. For closed interval, our circle will be solid. And this is an open interval, right? So for open interval, our circle will be a whole circle, okay? And we connect these two points. And this is our interval. Okay?
Yes.
So now see something different. So here is modulus x plus modulus y is less than or equal to 1. So this means it will be less than on or equal to 1, right? You can see here less than or equal to. So now we can just take this equation and we can graph this. So after graphing this equation, we will find our solution, and then we just okay, let me show you. So this is our Cartesian coordinate. This is y and this is x. And we know that this coordinate is plus and plus, right? Both x and y will be plus here. And for this coordinate, x is minus and y is plus. For this coordinate, x is minus and y is also minus. And for this coordinate, x is plus and y is minus. So we have to just, we are taking this equation, okay? And for modulus x, we know two things. Number one is, for modulus x, we can get plus x and also minus x. And for modulus y, we can get plus y and also minus y. Right?
Yes.
So now, for this coordinate, this is plus and plus, right? So x will be plus and y will be also plus. So we write this way. We can, so for this equation, we can write this way. X plus y is equal to 1, because in this first coordinate, x is plus and y is also plus. So now you just keep y on the left side and everything else on the right side. So this will make y is equal to 1 minus x. So we can compare this equation with our general linear equation, okay? So general linear equation is y is equal to mx plus c. So that means here our slope is minus 1 and y intercept is plus 1, right? So we only take y intercept. So for y intercept, plus 1 will be somewhere around here, right? You can see here the value of y. So this is our y intercept and on is here. So now you have to just put some value. For example, every time I take x is equal to 1, okay? I can take anything else. So if x is equal to 1, then it will make 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. That means y is equal to 0. So we have to put this coordinate pair in our graph. So this will be here. Okay? So we get 2 points. We get 2 points. 1 is here and another 1 is here. And we have to just connect these 2 points. Okay? So this way we get our first line, okay? Now let's go to the second coordinate. So for second coordinate, we know that x will be minus and y will be plus, right? So we can write this way, minus x plus y. Minus x plus y is equal to 1. It comes from this equation, okay? So now we again have to keep y on the left side and everything else on the right side. So you can see here, this is y. So this makes y is equal to 1 plus x. So our y-intercept is 1. So this will be here. And if we put some value here, for example, x is equal to 1. So this will make 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So for x is equal to 1, we get y is equal to 2. Now we have to put this coordinate pair. So 1 comma 2 will be here. This is our 1 and 2 will be on 2 here, right? Again. Somewhere around here. So this is our 1 comma 2 point. So we get 2 point. This is 1 comma 2 and this is y intercept. Okay. So if we connect these two lines, we get a straight line like this way. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now for the third coordinate, x is minus and y is also minus, right? So here we can write this way. Minus x minus y is equal to 1. Now keep y on the left side. So we will get c intercept is equal to minus 1, right? So here is our minus 1 point. And if we take some value here, for example, x is equal to 1. So this will make 1 minus 1, that means 0. So if x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0. So 1 comma 0 point will be here. This will be minus 2, right? If we take x is equal to 1, this will be minus 1 minus 1. So minus 1 is equal to minus 2, right? So for x is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 2. So on comma minus 2 will be where? This is our on and minus on minus 2. Somewhere around here, right? So we get this point and this point. Now we have to connect these 2 points. So we get our third line, okay? Now for the fourth coordinate, we know that here x will be plus and y will be minus, right? So we can write this way, x minus y is equal to 1. And now keep y on the left side and you get our y-intercept is equal to minus 1. So this will be our y-intercept, this point, okay? And if we put some value here, for example, x is equal to 1, so y will be 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So for x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0. So this will be 1 comma 0 here, right? So now we connect these 2 points. So this is our graph. And as a modulus x plus modulus y is less than or equal to 1, that means our solution will be in between this, okay? In between these four line. This is our solution, okay? Andani, you got it?
Yes. Yeah, I got it.
Okay. Now we can move forward to our lecture three. Okay, in lecture three we have we have to find the distance between two points, for example A and B. So if A and B are two points, and the distance between these two points will be root over del x squared plus del y squared. Okay, and del x is increment in the x axis. Okay, so this will be x2 minus x1, and del y is equal to increment in y, that is y2 minus y1. Okay, and we say del x means run and del y means rise. This is our rise and this is our run. Okay,
yes.
And now here is two points. For example, A is equal to 3, 4, -3, and B is equal to 2, 5. So for these two points, our del x will be 2 - 4, and del y will be 5 - -3. So this will make -2, 8. And m is equal to del y divided by del x. Okay, m means slope. Slope is equal to del y divided by del x. So here we have del y is equal to 8 and del x is equal to -2. So this will make -4. So our slope is -4. Okay, so this way we just find rise and run. This is our run and this is our rise. Kondoni, you got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, so here is our rules. That is, slope is equal to m is equal to rise by run is equal to del y by del x is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Okay, so we can move forward. So there is another important theory. So this is, if the value of slope is less than 0, this will be a downhill. Okay, that means if this is our graph, so our line will be from like this way, from A to B. Okay, and the and if m is greater than 0 or slope is greater than 0, so it will be uphill, something like this way. Okay, this is our A and this is our B. Mm-hmm. And if m1 is greater than m2, if slope on is greater than slope, if m1 is greater than m2, the rise of m1 is also greater than m2. That means, for example, this is our this is a line and this is a line. So you can see here, this line is something like very upward, right? So this is our m1 and this is our m2. So here m1 will be greater than m2. Okay, because we can see here this slope is very very upward, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so if m1 is greater than m2, the rise of m1 is greater than m2. So you can see here, where is the rise? Rises from this point, right? And here rises this point. So you can easily see here, this rise is greater than this. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So now let's see an example here. So here is two point. A is equal to a minus three two, and b -1, -2. So we have to. We have to calculate the increment in x. Okay, that means del x. So del x is equal to x2 - x1. So this is our x2 - x1. This will make 2. And increment in y is equal to del y. So this is y2 - y1. Okay, so this will make -2 - -2 - -2. That is -4. So now we can calculate our slope. slope is equal to del y divided by del x. That means minus 4 divided by 2. So it will make minus 2. Now we can draw our graph. So here is xy axis. And so our increment is x is equal to 2, right? 1, 2. And increment is y equal to minus 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So increment is x equal to 2 and increment is y equal to minus 4. So if we just connect these 2 points, this point and this point, okay, the last 2 point, then we will get our line. Okay.
Yes.
You can see here, if we draw another horizontal and vertical line, so this will make like this way, right? So this two, this is our increment in x, or this is called run, right? Run. And here is hot, here is minus 4. So this minus 4 is, will be our rise or increment in y axis. Okay. So this way we can draw our graph. So now let's move to another example. So if the inclination of a horizontal line is 0 degree, and the inclination of a vertical line is 90 degree. So vertical means, you look at the word V. This is standing, right? So this is a vertical line. And you look the word S. So for S, we have this some line like this, right? So this is a horizontal line. So for a horizontal line, inclination is 0 degree. You can see here, it is making 0 degree angle with x-axis, right? This is our x-axis, and this line, and this line. These two are making 0 degree. So that's why inclination of a horizontal line is 0 degree. And inclination of a vertical line is 90 degree. So vertical means this line, okay? So this line is making 90 degree with x-axis, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now let's see another thing. If the inclination is 90 degree, so the equation will be x is equal to a. Why? Because this is our line. This is our vertical line. So we can see here every time value of x is equal to a, right? So for example, a point is in here, or a point in here, or a point in here. So for all these 3 points, our value of x will be always minus. So that's why we can write this way, x is equal to a, right? So for this 3 point, value of x will be always a. That's why we write for this line, equation will be x is equal to a. Okay. And for this line, inclination is 0 degree. That means slope is 0 degree. And for this line, there is no slope. So do you know why for this red line there is no slope? Do you know the reason? Because this is a vertical line. So slope must be a non-vertical line, okay? And if this is vertical, that means we know slope is equal to tan phi, right? Slope m is equal to tan phi. That means for vertical line, this angle will be 90 degree. And if you put this value in your calculator, you can see tan 90 is equal to undefined, right? So that's why slope must be a non-vertical line. So in for this line we have no slope. So let's see some more example here. So Lauchy will give us some equation like this. Lauchy will give us a point, and will give us a slope. Okay. For example, this will be P 2, 3. Okay. And for example, slope is equal to -3/2. So we have to find the equation for this line. So a line that is passing through this point, this line L is passing through this point, and it has a slope of -3/2. So our equation will be y is equal to y1 plus m into x minus x1. Y is equal to y1 plus m into x minus x1. So now we have to, this is our x1, right? And this is our y1. So x1, y1. So we just put this value here, y1 and x1, okay? And m is equal to -3/2. We just put this -3/2 here. So if you input all this value, so it will make an equation like this. y is equal to 3 - 3/2, x minus 2, okay? So now we can multiply this 3/2 with x and also with minus 2. So it will make -3/2 x, and this will be -3/2 × -2 = 3. And this minus and this minus will become plus, okay? So this is +3. And we have another +3 here. So all this together, this is -3/2 × 3 + 3, okay? So this will be -3/2 × 6. So this is the equation y is equal to -3/2 × 6. This is the equation for a line that is passing through P2, 3 point, and it has a slope of -3/2, okay? Kondon, you got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, so maybe these are same. Okay, no, this is different. Number 2.2 is different. So previously we had a point and a slope, right? But now we have 2 points. We have 2 points. And this will be given. Our Lauchy will give us a question like this. Now we have to find the equation of a line that is passing through 3, 4 and -2, 5 point. So now for this, our equation will be y is equal to y y1 plus m into x minus x1. Okay, y is equal to y1 plus m into, y is equal to y1 plus m into x minus x1. So if there is some point given, like this way, here is some point given. So we will use this equation. And if there is no point given, then we will use y is equal to mx plus b. Okay? So I will come it right after some moment. So now let's find the slope. Slope will be del y divided by del x, right? So this is 5 - 4 and -2 - 3, right? 5 - 4 - 2 - 3. So this will be on divided by -5. So this is our slope. And we just put this value here, right? This is our slope. And x1 is equal to what? So do not make mistake. Here x1 and y1 is here. This is x1 and this is y1. Okay, it is not here. Okay, it is not here. It is here. This is x2 and y2. Okay, this is x2, y2. But we do not need x2, y2. We need x1, y1. So that means our x1 will be 3 and y1 will be 4. So this is 3 and this is 4. Now just simplify this and you will get minus 1 by 5x plus 23 by 5. Okay, so this is our equation. So now let's move forward. Now we have to find y-intercept and x-intercept, okay? So this 20 is same like before. So I'm skipping this, okay? So number 22, we have a slope 1 by 2 and y-intercept is equal to minus 3. So that means m will be only divided by 2 and y-intercept is called b, okay? So this will be minus 3. So you can see here there is no point given, right? Point means 2, 0, something like this. So here is no point given. That means we will use this equation, y is equal to mx plus b, okay? So here you just put the value of m and value of b. So it will be half x minus 3. So now let's go to another example. We have to write an equation of a line that is passing through minus 12, minus 9 point, and it has a slope 0. So slope 0 means m is equal to 0, right? So as there is a point given, that means our equation will be y is equal to y1 plus m into x minus x1, right?
Yes.
So if m is equal to 0, then this total value will be 0, right? And we only get y is equal to y1. That means y is equal to b. Y is equal to y1. Y1 is here. Y1 is here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is y1. So y is equal to y1. That means y is equal to, we can write this way, y is equal to b. Or this is our y-intercept. Okay? You can notice here this y-intercept, okay? We call this intercept as b. So for this line, this will be y is equal to b, right?
Yes.
So that's why we write y is equal to b. And here b is equal to minus 9. So I just made mistake here. This will be minus 9, okay? So let's go to the next question. So we have to find a, oh, this is also like same. This is passing through minus 1,4 point and it has no slope. It has no slope means this is a vertical line. You remember?
Yeah.
That slope must be a non-vertical line. That means if there is no slope, that means this is a vertical line, this line. And for this line, you can see here, we got x is equal to a. Okay? So for this line, our equation will be x is equal to a. So here a is equal to what? 1 divided by 3, okay? 1 divided by 3, this is a. This is a and this is b. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So x is equal to 1 divided by 3. Now let's go to some more example. So we have to find, here is our x and y axis. And we have to find the equation of line that is passing through 5, minus 1 point. And this is parallel to this line. That means we have to find a line that is like this way and passing through 5 minus 1, like where is 5 minus 1? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And minus 1 will be here, right? So this is passing through this point and it is parallel to this line. So our line will be somewhere like this. And we have to find another line is given. And for this line, equation is? For this line, equation is 2x plus 5y is equal to 15. So we have to find this line, okay? So now, this is our x on, this is our y on. And we know that, so we have to firstly calculate the slope. Because without slope, we do not find the equation, okay? You look at the theory. The law is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So this law is like same before. Y is equal to y1 plus m into x minus x1. You remember this?
Yes.
So this equation and this equation, these two are the same, okay? So for this equation, we need the value of m or slope. So to find slope, we have to solve this equation. We have to solve this equation. So to solve this line, we can just put y on the left side and everything else on the right side. So this will make y is equal to minus 2 by 5x plus 3. So you can compare this with our general linear equation. This is y is equal to mx plus c. That means our m will be minus 2 by 5, right?
Yes.
Okay. So here I write m is equal to minus 2 by 5. So now we already know the value of m. And x on and y on is already given. You see here, this is x on and this is y on, right? So we have to just put all the number here. Then we will get y is equal to minus 2 by 5x plus 1. So this way we solve, we find the equation of a line that is parallel to this line. That is parallel to this line and it is passing through this point. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Kondoni, please let me understand that if this is easy or not.
Can you repeat that question again?
Yeah, of course, yes. So here is our x and y axis. And we have to find a equation of a line. So here on line is given. Suppose this is a line, okay? On line is given. And for this line, equation is 2x plus 5y is equal to 15. Okay, for this line. Now we have to find the slope. We have to find the slope from this line. So we can just write this, we have to convert this line into y is equal to mx plus c, something like this, okay? So for this, we can keep this 5y on the left side and everything else on the right side, okay? So this will make 5y is equal to minus 3x plus 15. And now we divided 5 here. So this will be, also we have to divide 5 here and here. So this will be y is equal to minus 2 by 5, y is equal to minus 2 by 5x plus 3. So if we compare this equation with our general linear equation, so our slope is equal to minus 2 by 5, right? So we will write this way, m is equal to minus 2 by 5. And now we already know that for a line that is passing through x on y on point, okay? For a line that is passing through a specific point, our equation will be y minus y on is equal to m into x minus x on. So here we just put our value. For example, x on is equal to what? This is our x on, this is our y on. So 5 and minus 1. So this is y on minus 1. And this is x5, okay? And we already found the slope. This is minus 2 by 5. So in this slope, here in slope, we write minus 2 by 5. So this is our equation. And now if you simplify these three lines, you can get y is equal to minus 2 by 5x plus 1. Okay? So now you got it?
What is the y equals to minus 2 over 5x plus 1 coming from?
Which line?
This one.
Could you please annotate in the screen?
Explain from this point. Wait, wait.
Sorry?
These 2 points.
This part or this part?
The one that I've annotated.
Oh, this here. Part. Okay. Yeah, I got it. So you can see here, this is our equation, right? And we just put all the value here, y on and m and x on, and we already found all this value, right? This is x on, this is y on, and this is m. So I put it all this value here. You see here, x on 5, y on minus 1, and m is equal to minus 2 by 5. So now this will make minus minus, that means plus y plus 1, and here I just multiply minus 2 by 5 with x and also with 5. So this will make minus 2 by 5x and 10 by 5. Okay, this minus and this minus will become plus 10 by 5. And now we just multiply 5. Okay, we just multiply 5 here. Okay, we can do another thing. Here we have a plus on here, right? So we took this plus on from left side to right side, so this will become minus on, and 5 and 10, this will get cancelled and we get only 2, right?
Yes.
So this will make plus 2 minus on. So plus 2 minus on means plus on. So our final line is y is equal to minus 2 by 5x plus 1.
Oh.
So now you understand?
Yes, I understand.
Okay, thank you. So let's see another example. A line that is passing through minus root over 2 comma 2, and it's parallel to line this. So this is parallel to this line. That means we have a line that is passing through minus 2 root 2 and 2, right? So this will be here, passing through this point, and it is parallel to, for example, this is a line and this is another line, okay? So these two lines are parallel, right? So for this line, our equation is given. This is our line, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And we have to find a line that is parallel to this line, okay? We have to find a line that is parallel to this line. So it means, firstly, we need the value of slope. So we solve this line and we get the slope here, minus root over 2 by 5. We found the slope the same way before, okay? Like this way. We just keep y on the left side and everything else on the right side. Then okay, the coefficient of x will be the slope, right? Coefficient of x will be the slope. So here slope is equal to minus root over 2 by 5. And this is our equation. This is our equation for a line that is passing through x on y on point. You remember this equation? The same equation that we used before. Okay, x on y on. So we just put all the value here, and then we will find y is equal to minus root over 2 by 5x plus 8 by 5. Okay? So this line equation will be y is equal to minus root over 2 by 5 x plus 8 by 5. Okay?
Okay.
So now let's move forward. So now we have to previously we saw parallel line, right? We saw parallel line. So now we have to, we will find perpendicular line. So perpendicular means, for example, this is a line. And another line is this way. So they are 90 degree angle, right?
Mm-hmm.
The angle is 90 degree. That means they are perpendicular. Okay? If a line is here and is, if a line is here, so this makes a 90 degree angle. So they are perpendicular. So here in our question, we have to, a line passes through 4, 10 and it is perpendicular to this line. So now we will solve this equation and we will find the value of M or slope. Okay? So if we find the slope, then for its perpendicular line, for example, this is our this line was given, right? This line was 6x minus 3y is equal to 5. And now we got for this line slope is equal to 2. So we have to find another line. For this is our another line. So for this line, our slope will be minus 1 by 2. Okay, or you can say this way. If M1 is equal to, so you can say this way, M1 is equal to minus 1 by M2, okay? Or this is called reciprocal value, negative reciprocal.
Mm-hmm.
You can see here, I just write 2 on the below, and I just write here and 1 on the upside. That means, it was 2, that means 2 by 1. I make it upside down, that means 1 divided by 2. And I just make a minus sign here. Okay?
Right.
This way we find the slope. The slope of a perpendicular line. So for a perpendicular line, here is our equation and we just put all the value. Like this is our M, this is Y1 and this is X1. All this value is given in the question. This is X1, this is Y1, and this is our slope, right? So you have to be make sure that you take this M, okay? Not this M. Because this slope is for this line that was given in the question. But this slope is for our answer, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So Kondoni. Do you understand?
Yes. Yes, I understand.
Okay, so we can move forward. So here is another example. A line that is passing through 0, 1 and is perpendicular to the point, to the line this. So that means we have to firstly calculate the slope. So our slope is 8 divided by 13, right? So ML or for this line, our slope is 8 by 13. So what will be M perpendicular? What will be the slope of a particular line? Perpendicular line. This will be, we just make it upside down. That means 8 by 13 will be 13 divided by 8. And we have to use a minus here, right? So this is minus 13 by 8. So now we have to just put all the value in our equation. So Y is equal to MX plus C.
All right.
So here our teacher skipped something, maybe like this one. So you can see here, okay, let me explain this. So this was y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Or you can write y is equal to y1 plus m minus y is equal to y1 plus m into x minus x1, right? So y1 is what?
Yes.
Y1 is here, 1. Okay, you can see here 1. So y is equal to 1 plus m is what? M is equal to 13 minus 13 by 8. So minus 13 by 8. So this is what plus? This will become minus, right? Minus 13 by 8. And x minus x1. X minus, you can see x1 is 0. So x minus 0, that means y is equal to minus 13x, minus 30 by 8x plus 1. You see here?
Mm-hmm.
So y is equal to minus 13 by 8x plus 1. Okay?
Yes.
So now, let's see how we can find the equation of a circle. So for circle, center will be h and k. We will call center h comma k, okay? And our radius, we will call it a. We will call center is equal to h comma k, and radius will be a. So for example, here our center is 0 comma 2. That means this is our 0 and this is our 1, 2. So here is our center, right? And a is equal to 2. That means you just go you just go anywhere from this center. Like you can go 2 on the upward, right? So you come up to here, and then you use your compass and make a circle. Okay?
Okay.
So for this circle, you can see our radius is 2 and our center is 0, 2. Okay? And for this circle, our equation will be x minus a whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to a square. For every circle, this is our general equation, okay? So this will become a x minus a is equal to what? 0, right? A is equal to this point, 0. And a is equal to this point. You see here? A is equal to this point and k is equal to this point. So this will make x minus 0 whole square plus y minus 2. Y minus 2 whole square is equal to, here is our radius, or a, right? So a square, that means 2a square.
Yes.
So it will make x square plus 2, y minus 2 whole square is equal to 4, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Andani, got it?
Yes, I got it.
Okay. So here is another example. We have C minus 3, 0. And so for this, H will be minus 3 and K will be 0. Right? A is K.
Mm-hmm.
And A is also given, A is 3. So firstly, you put this center here. So minus 3, 0 will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. And 0 will be here, right? So this is our center.
Yes.
And you take the radius, 3. You can take here or here, okay, anywhere from this point. So let's take 3 here, and now use your compass and a compass and make a circle. So this is our graph, okay? And for this circle, equation will be x minus a whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to a square. And you put all the value here, okay? This value is, this value k, okay? So this will make this equation. And this equation is the equation of this circle. Okay, you got it?
Got it.
So now we will learn some parabola. Okay, this is advanced mathematics, so we don't need advanced mathematics today. Okay, so see here. Now we will find some distance between 2 points. So, for example, here is our point A and here is our point B. P1, P2. See here, P1 and P2. So, distance between these 2 points will be root over del x square, root over del x square plus del y square. Okay? Root over del x square plus del y square. So del x means what? Del x means y2 minus y1. Or this is our rise. And del x means x2 minus x1. Right? x2 minus x1. This is our ramp. And del y means y2 minus y1. This is our rise. So if you square this del x and del y, and if you root this, you will find the distance between these two points. This point and this point, okay?
Okay.
So here is our teacher just simplified, okay, and wrote all the equation here. Like this is our point slope equation, this is our slope intercept equation. We already do these types of math before, okay?
Yes.
Like here you can see this is our slope. Where is slope? Slope is equal to m, and y intercept is equal to b here, right? Here is our y intercept. So y is equal to b. And here is our x intercept. X is equal to a. Okay. So we don't need to discuss these things because we already did a lot of math using these equations.
Yes.
So you see here, there is two points, P and Q. There is two points, P and Q. Here is P and here is Q. So the distance between these two points will be root over, you can see here, root over del x square plus del y square. That means x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 tar modulus whole square. Okay? So this will be, and if you want to find a distance of a point from the axis, if you want to find a distance from the axis, like this is our point and this is our axis, so their distance will be root over x square plus y square. Okay, this also comes from this equation. You just put this x1 equal to 0 and y1 is equal to 0, then you will get root over x square plus y square, okay? Mm-hmm. So this is the distance between distance from axis, okay? Suppose this is our point xy, and this equation is for the distance from axis, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now we have interior of a circle, interior of the circle and exterior of the circle. So if x minus a whole square plus y minus whole square is less than a square, so this means, yeah, bro, are you here?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. So, and if this is greater than a square, so what does this say? This a was our radius, right?
Yes.
Remember?
Yes.
So if this is greater than a square, then it will be a exterior, okay? Exterior circle. It will be the exterior of the circle. Got it?
Got it.
So here is the equation given. X square plus y square is equal to 1. So how do we find the radius? We know that it will be x square plus y square equal to a square, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if we write this way, like root over 1 whole square, this root and root and a square will get cancelled, right? And we will only get 1. That means our radius is equal to root over 1. Right, so root over 1 is 1. You can calculate it. This is, you know, calculator. Root over 1 is 1. So our radius is equal to 1. Okay, and as this is x square plus y square, that means the center is at the origin. right? Or at the 0, 0 point.
Mm-hmm.
So now we go, we take just on here and we make a circle because our radius is on, right?
Yes.
So we only take from this center to on here and we make our circle. So this is called a unit circle, okay? This mm-hmm. is called a unit circle. Now let's see another example. We have x square plus y square is equal to 2, right? So we knew that this 2 is a square, right? This 2 is a square.
Yes.
That means we can write this way, root over 2 whole square. So that means our a is equal to root over 2, right? A is equal to root over 2. So here I write radius is equal to root over 2. That means on point 4 on 4. And for this equation, our center is at the origin, right? Center is at the origin, or 0, 0 point. So from 0, 0 point, we take root over 2 here, and we draw our circle. Okay. And here is an example for interior circle, interior of a circle. So firstly, we have to draw. We have to draw this equation, okay? Because this less than or equal to, this means it will be equal to, this less than or equal to, this means this will be equal to or less than, right? So we have to draw
a
circle for this equation. And we can find here our radius is root over 3 and center is 0, 0. So here is center and we go to root over 3 on the right side and we draw our circle, okay? And because as this is less than, as x square plus y square is less than a, so this is interior of the circle, right? You remember?
Mm-hmm.
So our circle will be like this way. Okay?
Okay.
So here is another example. Here is our center and this is our radius. So we know that our general equation is x minus a whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to a square. So if we make this a square, that will be this root and this a square will get cancelled and we will only get 2, right? So our equation mm-hmm. will be x minus a, this is a and this is k. That means x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 1 whole square is equal to 2. Got it?
So
this way we write down the equation for a circle. Now let's see parabola. So for a parabola, the general equation is y is equal to x square plus bx plus c, okay? And also we can say y is equal to x square. So in most of the case, we will use this equation. So now let's solve some parabola. And remember another thing. If a is greater than 0, this will open upward. And if a is less than 0, this will open downward, okay? So where is a? This is our a, right? So remember, if a is greater than 0, it will be upward, like upward means like this way. And if a is less than 0, this will be downward, okay? Like this way. Got it?
Got it.
So I'm giving you an example of it. So here is only two rule, okay? Number one is can you see this parabola?
Yes.
So vertex means the top point or the bottom point of a parabola, okay? Vertex means the top point of or a bottom point of a parabola. That means if this is our for example, this is a mountain, okay? And here is our top point. So this point will be vertex. Or for example, this is a lake. And for this lake, this is our bottom point. So this is our vertex. So to find the vertex, we have to use the this rule. Vertex will be minus b by 2a. Minus b by 2a. Comma. 4ac. Minus b square by 4a. Okay. Vertex will be this. And we already know all these points. A, B, and C. So where do you find ABC? From the equation of the parabola, okay? You can see here, this is A, this is B, and this is C. This ABC will given in the question, okay? So just put all the value here, and you will find the point of vertex. And another law is the axis. So for the axis, equation will be x is equal to minus b by 2a, okay? And you just input the value of b and a here, and you will get the axis. Okay, I will show you real example, okay? I'm just reminding you the rules.
All right.
And now let's see a real example. So here we have here in the question we have to graph a parabola, and also we have to label the vertex, and also we have to find the axis. We have to label the vertex and axis, and also have to find the x-intercept and y-intercept, okay? So in the question, this will be given. This is our equation. And for this equation, here is A, right? A is equal to 1 here. Here is nothing, that means here is 1. And here is B. B is equal to minus 2. And here is C, okay?
Yes.
So here is A and B and C. And now vertex will be minus b by 2a, comma b square minus b square plus 4ac by 4a. So you just put all the value here. B here, then a here, okay? So it will make 1, comma minus 4. So 1, comma minus 4 is our vertex. And for axis, we know the equation is x is equal to minus b by 2a. So again, put all the value here, and you will get on, right? So that means
yes,
our axis is x is equal to 1, and I will show you all the things in the graph, okay? So our axis is x is equal to 1, and this axis will be a vertical line. Okay, now let's find x intercept and y intercept. For x intercept, we know y is equal to 0. Why? Because for example, this is a line, and for x-intercept, you can see here every time y is equal to 0, right? Here every time y is equal to 0. That's why we have to put y is equal to 0. So if we put y is equal to 0, we will get two values, x is equal to 3 and x is equal to minus 1. So our point will be 3, 0 and minus 1, 0. Okay, 3, 0, minus 1, 0. And if we want to find the y-intercept, so for y-intercept, x will be 0, okay?
So here, wait, where those coordinates?
And we will find y is equal to minus 3. So x, for x is equal to 0, y is equal to minus 3, right? And let's put all these values here, like, so do you have any problem, any of this system?
The coordinates, where are they coming from?
Oh, these two coordinates, right?
Yes, this one and this one.
So for x-intercept, we know that y is equal to 0, right? So our where is our question? Here is our question, right? So here in y, we put 0, okay? So here is 0.
Yes.
Now we have to solve this, these things. So it will become, we can write minus 2x like this way, like minus 3x plus x. This will become minus 2x, right? And then we just take x common. We just take x common. That means we just divide here x. Okay? That means this x and this x get cancelled and we get only on x here. Okay? So if we take x common, so here on x will get cancelled, then we get only x. And here also on x will get cancelled. Then we get 3. Okay?
Okay.
I mean, we have to just divide x here and we have to multiply x here. So this this x is here, right? This one.
Mm-hmm.
And if you multiply x square minus 3x divided by x. So if you calculate these things, it will be x and x get cancelled. Then that means we have only one x here. And here x and x get cancelled and we get 3 here. And now here we just take plus on as a common, okay? Or we just divide on here and we multiply on here. So this will make on into x minus 3, okay? So you see here, here is on x minus 3 and x minus 3. So we can common this x minus 3, okay? Or we can take it once. And we have also minus, we have also x and plus on. So we write x and plus on here, okay? So this will be x minus 3 into x minus 1. And now we know a thing. We know a thing. If a and b is equal to 0, then a will be 0 and b will be 0, okay? So using this theory, we can write x minus 3 is equal to 0. So if x minus 3 is equal to 0, if x minus 3 is equal to 0, so x will be plus 3, right? So here x is equal to 3. And if this is equal, x plus 1 is equal to 0, so x will be minus 1, right? So okay, this way we get the value of x. And for the value of x is equal to 3 and minus 1, y is always 0, right? So firstly we take this 3 and 0, and then we take this 1, 0. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this will make 3, 0 and on, minus 1, 0. Kondani, got it?
Got it.
Okay. So again, for your intercept, x is equal to 0, then we put value of x is equal to 0 here. So this will make y is equal to minus 3. And now we have to put this 3, 0, this minus 1, 0, this minus 0, 3, okay? And this vertex point in the graph. So you can see here. Firstly, I took the vertex 1, -4, okay? Here is the vertex.
Mm-hmm.
Now I take x-intercept 3, 0 and minus 1, 0. Here is x-intercept. 3,0 minus 1,0. Okay. Now we take y-intercept. That is y-intercept is 0, -3. So that will be 0 and minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Okay? Somewhere around here. So now now just we get this point, this point, this point, and this point. And now let's connect this 4 point, okay? Then we get our parabola. Kandani, got it?
Mm-hmm. Got it.
So here is everything. And look at another thing. Here our value of a is minus 1, right? So do not make mistake. I draw the graph this way. You can see here, because you already know that if y is equal to x square plus bx plus c is less than zero, right? Less than zero. That means, this is not like a thing. If a is less than zero. So the parabola will be downward, right? Downward. Yes, and if a is greater than zero, parabola will be upward. So here we can see a is equal to minus one, right? So this parabola is downward. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes.
So here is everything, and do you have any problem?
No problem.
Okay, so we will discuss about advanced mathematics in the later class, okay? Today only foundation mathematics.
All right, just send me this note.